I did a poll asking Cubase users if they prefer Groove Agent or the new drum machine to program drums. About 70% said Groove Agent, but to my surprise, a bunch of people commented, neither. I use a sampler track. And that got me thinking. I too use a sampler track for some parts of the drums. So I thought I'd do a quick video showing how I use each of those tools. If you use them in a different way, feel free to share it in the comments, because I'm curious to know. First up, what's the same across Groove Agent, drum machine, and the sampler track is the actual programming. You draw or play the notes in the key editor or the drum editor, or you create a pattern event, and then you can use a step sequencer. The biggest difference is the source of the sounds. In Groove Agent and drum machine, it's kind of similar. You choose a kit or upload multiple samples to the pads, and then you can still manipulate every sound. In drum machine, it's a little easier to create your own sound because it's also a drum synth, and you can easily layer sounds. On a sampler track, you upload just one sound, which you can also manipulate in all kinds of ways. But if you would do drums like a kick, snare, and hi-hat, you would have to create a new sampler track for every one of those sounds. Whereas Groove Agent and Drum Machine have multiple outputs. So when you're programming in Groove Agent or Drum Machine, you can have the whole drum kit in one event, which is very practical. If you're working with sampler tracks and you want the same kind of overview, you have to select all the events, and then you kinda have the same thing. So I can do my kick, snare, and so on, but it's less practical. And you might be like, but how do I mix my individual drum parts when I'm using Groove Agent or Drum Machine? Because all the sounds are in one MIDI file. So that's what the multiple outputs are for. In Groove Agent, and be sure to add it as a rec instrument, you right-click a pad and assign it to its own output. So start with 2, and the next output for the next pad, and so on. And then you see in the project window that these new channels are getting added, and these are the separate sounds that you can mix like any other track, and you can also export them if you want the separate WAV files. Kind of the same thing with Drum Machine, right-click and assign. Here you can also go to Group and assign the outputs here. Unlike with Groove Agent, the new channels do not show in the project window, but they are still in the mixer, so you can still mix and export those the same way. One extra difference in Drum Machine that can come in handy is the hot swap. That's an easy way to preview and replace sounds. So let's say these are my drums, but the snare is not really going with the rest of the music, so I want to replace it. I can either swap the whole pad or just one layer, and I'm just going to go through my snares. And if I'm happy with one, I'm going to apply the swap. So now it's replaced. Back to the sampler track. What I do use it for is for things that need tuning. For example, in trap songs, you often hear a tuned hi-hat. So I'll have all of my drums except for the hi-hat together in one Groove Agent or Drum Machine event, and then a sampler track for the hi-hat. And then you can create this kind of thing really easily. If you use a pattern event on a sampler track, you can also do this, but to me, it's not as straightforward. So you can do repeats. And if you go to add parameter, you can add pitch. A pattern event on a drum machine track, in that case, you'd have to assign the pitch control to the parameters like this, and then choose it in here. So you can see the automation here. And one more thing that you can consider to be part of the drums that I use the sampler track for is 808s. You can drag an 808 sample in here, tell it what the root note is so you can play the correct notes. And right now the higher notes are shorter. If you don't want that, click Audio Warp. And if you want to do slides, make it monophonic. Legato mode, and give it a little glide. And then here, with the glide note, if you let it overlap, hold Command or Control to override snap. All right, I hope you got something out of this. Thanks for watching and have fun making music.